I am the first senior White House advisor in the history of our republic that has ever been charged with this alleged crime. And I say alleged because for hundreds of years, this has not been a crime. And for 50 years, the Department of Justice has maintained the principle of absolute testimonial immunity. And it was only with my case that somehow that has changed.
Former Donald Trump aide Peter Navarro displaying how he is genuinely a real pioneer in crime. And of course, he had to report for prison, federal prison in Miami today, making history as the first former White House official to be imprisoned for contempt of Congress. Now, of course, he is playing the victim. You heard a little bit of it in that clip. And he did speak for 30 minutes outside of a gas station, outside of the courthouse. And let's hear just a little more of what he had to say, and then we'll get into the details of how the Supreme Court, the very conservative Supreme Court, with three Supreme Court justices that Donald Trump handpicked himself, basically gave Navarro the middle finger and said, time for you to go to prison. Let's watch.
Here's where the homework is, because the big constitutional separation of powers are these. Can Congress compel a senior White House advisor, what they call the alter ego of a president, to testify before Congress? And executive privilege goes back to George Washington and his remarks to the Congress regarding the Jay Treaty. And he said very simply and clearly, succinctly, elegantly, that to write to the Congress, he said, I cannot command you as members of Congress to come to me. You cannot command me to come to you.
Wow, that was compelling, Cenk.
Yeah.
Are you persuaded? Maybe you should be free for contempt of Congress.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us. So I'm going to tell you why he's actually holding out. It has nothing to do with principles, but let me quickly dismiss his nonsense case. And you can tell it's nonsense because all the courts said it's nonsense, and that's why he's going to prison. Number one, this was about things he did during the 2020 election, which have nothing to do with his official role in the White House. If they did have something to do with his role in the White House, that would be a violation of the Hatch Act, and it would be illegal. So that would be a different crime. Okay. So by definition, it has nothing to do with it. Second of all, Trump did not actually use the privilege that he's talking about, did not claim the privilege he's talking about. And third of all, the reason he's going to jail, whereas almost no one else has before other than one Bush official for a day, is because normally they go back and forth and they negotiate and it becomes really difficult. And usually the other side gives something in return. In this case, he didn't respond to anything. He did not involve himself in the process at all, which no one else has ever done. Okay, so that was basically saying contempt. You want to see contempt. I'm not going to do anything that Congress or the courts order me. And the courts are like, well, if you don't do what the courts order you, you go to jail. That's how it works. And so that's why he's going to jail. So why is he doing this? For martyrdom, etc.? Maybe a little bit because MAGA will love this and think that he's a patriot forever. But mainly they're asking him, hey, wait, didn't you write a book about how you wanted to steal the 2020 election and it came up with fake electors and a coup plot?
Which is give why he got subpoenaed.
That's what he got subpoenaed for. So give us that, the information you have on that. He knows that that's a much larger crime. He doesn't want to give him that information. So he pretends he's doing this on principles and goes, oh, I'm a martyr. I'm doing this for Donald Trump and what is right about constitutional principles. No, there's not a court in the country who thinks you're right on constitutional principles. You're doing this to save your own ass on a much larger crime.
And he claimed, you know, as part of his defense in the contempt charge, well, look, I mean, Donald Trump told me not to cooperate with the congressional investigation into January 6th, and I was doing as he told. as he told me to do. But the problem with that is you would have to provide evidence that that was the case, and he failed to provide a shred of evidence to the judge that that was the case. And so even though Navarro attempted to appeal, even though Navarro went to the Supreme Court and asked for their help, Chief Justice John Roberts rejected Navarro's request on Monday of this week. Navarro told reporters that he predicts the legal tactics that were used against him would now be used on Trump. He said, quote, "I'm pissed. That's what I'm feeling right now. But I'm also afraid of only one thing. I'm afraid for this country, because this, what they're doing, should have a chilling effect on every American, regardless of their party. They come for me, they can come for you."
No, we didn't try to steal an election, brother.
Or refuse to cooperate with a subpoena.
Yeah. Like,
you guys try ignoring a subpoena, by the way. Let's see how that works out for you.
Exactly. I mean, he's saying, now if they put me in prison for ignoring a subpoena, that means you can't ignore a subpoena either. Yeah, that's exactly what it means. And that's why they're putting you in jail, because no one can ignore a subpoena.
Okay, so look, he's gonna have a great time in prison. Just based on what I've read about the prison he's going to and the certain privileges that he will be given, even though he's a criminal, right? So let's skip ahead to that. So he's expected to spend 90 days behind bars. Little bit of a break from the real world, could be nice, okay? So let me give you some details. So he could serve only 90 days because he is eligible for early release. He's hoping to be assigned to an air-conditioned dormitory reserved for elderly male inmates, according to Sam Mangle, the prison consultant Navarro hired to prepare for his incarceration.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I didn't even know those people existed, but there's like prison consultants.
I mean, there's so many white-collar criminals that there's an industry of prison consultants.
No, it's amazing. For a certain class of prisoners.
Exactly, that's why I said white-collar criminals. Yeah. You think the guy who robbed a 7-Eleven down the street has the money for a prison consultant?
I love how it's a negotiation. Like, look at here, see? You would like some air conditioning, and we think we can do that for you. Hire us, low, low price. Okay, anyway, but more details. So to prepare for his incarceration, the dormitory houses 80 men in bunk beds, Mangle told CNN, and there will be no privacy in the dorm. Now, the prison is one of the older ones in the country. It sits next to a city zoo, and the same person, that prison consultant that we heard from earlier, says, not only can you hear the lions, you can hear the lions roar every morning. This sounds really fun, actually.
And that's supposed to somehow be intimidating. It's not like they're gonna let the lions inside the jail.
Yeah.
Okay.
He'll have access to TVs that are set up in the prison. So he'll be able to follow the news, watch his shows. He'll also have access to email, and he'll be able to make phone calls. He's gonna be all right.
In other words, good. He can get the Young Turks in jail, okay?
I'm sure he's watching right now.
Okay. Hey Pete, how you doing?